Welcome to Art for Film's Sake. I'm Stephen Reed,
and this is The Thin Red Line by Joao Ruas. Terrence Malick got the name for his 1998 masterpiece from an old Midwestern saying. Only a thin red line between the sane and the mad. The film is a captivating study of humanity set against the backdrop of the horrors of the Second World War. Most of the film gets inside the heads of the men of C Company as they battle the Japanese to retake strategic positions on the island of Guadalcanal in the Pacific. Needless to say, it isn't a cheery film. I think we should all know by now that war is bad and it messes you up. Private Bell, played by Ben Chaplin, sums it up succinctly.
You get something twisted out of your insides by all this blood, filth, and noise.
What kind of poster can possibly capture all this? All the death, the carnage, the pointlessness of it all. This one can. This haunting image is a chillingly powerful evocation of the damage done to those who've been through the insanity of war. The demonic soldier with its piercing one-eyed gaze. Those floating faces. That creeping hand. The twisting branches and foliage bleeding into a hazy, smoke-filled sky. All beautifully painted in the artist's trademark dark and murky yet vibrant style. Ruas has created something that makes you want to look away, but somehow you can't. You're mesmerised by the horror of it. Just what is happening here? Let's look again at those twisted roots. They appear to have suffocated the life out of this poor soldier long ago. Combined with that dark, thick foliage, they clamour and creep around him like a malevolent scarf. It's a simple and brutally effective representation of not only the unforgiving terrain of the Pacific jungle, but of the asphyxiating experience of war.
Look at this jungle. Look at those vines, the way they twine around the trees, swallowing everything. Nature's cruel, Staros.
But we can still see enough of the face behind to see that this soldier was once human. Once full of hope and dreams. Now drained of life, just an empty stare. That piercing white dot stares through us for 1,000 yards, further still into a place of darkness and despair. And those other faces, do they represent the different masks men have to wear in the theatre of war? Stoic, bereft, vicious. Or are they just the faces of other soldiers who know that it won't be long until the madness engulfs them too? Like that hand, they desperately cling on to what little humanity they have left. And then you notice that bright red dog tag, standing out defiant against the murky green grief.
a beacon of hope, perhaps, a signal that there is a way out of it all. Maybe we can go home when this is all over, unscathed, and life will be exactly as it was before. I don't think so. If anything, it's an easy target for the enemy soldiers to cut you down with a perfectly placed bullet. It also draws your eye down to that fantastic title treatment. Compact and centrally aligned along with the credit block, they really hold the whole composition together. Standing defiant amongst the madness, it also reminds us that it's just a poster after all. But what a poster it is. A haunting, twisted look at the horrors of war. Something that none of us ever want to see. But somehow, you can't stop looking. Thank you.